Let's talk about perception. What is perception? Perception is the way we see things. It's the way we react to certain things based on the analysis that we quickly make in our brain to assess every single situation in life. Perception depends on our previous experiences. Mostly that's what it is. Our previous experiences, what we've been taught, what we think is right, what we think is wrong, our beliefs. Based on that, we perceive things. You can say it, maybe the word is also judge, maybe we judge things, or maybe we observe things in certain way. Think about, you'd say, all right, well, fine. What about our vision? Because, you know, we look at something and that's pretty basic function of our body and our mind to look at things and understand what they are. Well, guess what? Your vision works in a way that your eye gathers the information from outside of you and then it sends signals to your visual cortex. Your visual cortex doesn't know what you're looking at. You need to interpret it. Your brain needs to interpret it. And the way your brain interprets it, it's trying to figure out if it's seen it before or trying to make connections if it hasn't seen it before, you know, to understand what they are. So, for example, you're walking on the street and you're seeing a stranger, right? It's a human being, it's the person. Your reaction to that stranger is that I don't know them because you looked at them, your brain scanned your mental images, and your brain is like, no, thank you very much. We need to stay away from a stranger because that's what our parents taught us. As an opposite, if you walk on the street and you see a friend of yours that you love and you're excited to see, all of a sudden, your brain and your vision, your eyes, scans that person, right? And you get excited. You get excited because it interpreted this image as something happy. So this is just a very basic scenario that shows you how it's all up to us to look at things the way we look at things. It's all up to us to be in a, say, happy situation, to be in something, in some good environment, and you know, be excited about that, be happy about that. Or it's up to you to be in that happy environment and find something negative, start being jealous about people that created this happy environment, that created this amazing vibe around you, because you just come up with different excuses. Oh, they're prettier than you, or maybe not prettier than you, they're smarter or more successful, and you create this negativity around you because your brain, you allow your mind to go there because you are not controlling your mind. So if you would like to do this little exercise and start paying attention to your own reactions, to the objects around you, to the situations around you, and trying to see, are you mostly negative or are you mostly positive? And if are you mostly negative, why are you negative? What is it that triggers that negative emotion in you? Once you figure that out, then we need to start working on how to identify that emotion and then how to turn that emotion first to neutral, because it's a huge leap from negative to the positive, and then to the positive. We need to start identifying how to see glass half full, not half empty. That's a lot of work. It's not gonna come easy. Some people are just positive from, you know, from their nature. Most of people are not positive because negativity is kind of a default emotion in a human being. So don't worry, we are all the same, we're not alone. We are all actually going through very similar exercises and similar, you know, problems in life. Some of us just figure out how to deal with them, and some of us are still struggling to, you know, identify it, and, you know, we just need help and a little push. So let's start with that. Let's start paying attention and identifying our reactions to things and our emotions, and then we're gonna dig deeper and try to figure out what the cause of those emotions and how to turn them into the neutral first and then positive. Until next time, bye.